It was... I was getting frustrated.
I could tell you, man, like I said, I knew you were, I knew it was wearing on your face because, you know, I could just see over there. I could see the, that kind of, you get that stare and then your face kind of draws down and you're like.
I said, man, this is humbling.
I remember you saying that exact thing. I remember you're like, man, this is really humbling. So I'm sitting there, I was trying to be quiet. I was like, man, I'm like, this dude needs to catch some fish.
Good morning, fishing friends. Jason here again, another episode of Clear Fork Bass. And today, I'm gonna be hunting down those trout. Going with a friend, Brandon Smith, today. Old friend from high school. And this will be our first fishing trip together. And he knows some good spots in McDowell County. He's gonna take me and hopefully get me on my personal best trout today. So that's gonna be quite awesome. But to me, it's so weird packing for trout. I've got, of course, my waders, a book bag, and everything fits in my book bag, my camera equipment, and trout lures, and hopefully some of that Thorny Creek bait and tackle will kick into effect today and give me some of them big trout. And two fishing poles, so it's a lot different than what I'm used to for packing for a bass fishing trip when I pack 40, 50 pounds of tackle, you know. So it's going to be an interesting day, and I'm going to take you guys along with me. We'll see you out there. And Lord, please don't let me get addicted to this trout fishing. I have enough lures for bass and spend enough money on bass products as it is. Well, guys, I'm here with Brandon now. I introduced Eddie's name earlier and everything in the truck. It was too dark to do a lot of recording on the way over, but we're here and ready to hit the water. There's some people here already, so we're not going to do much introduction. We'll talk a little more later with Brandon and everything, but let's get on these trout. He's going to take me and show me around and hopefully get my personal best today, buddy.
We're going to work on it. We're here in beautiful North Fork, West Virginia.
Yeah, boy. First one of the day. We've been here, what, 5-10 minutes?
See, that's what I like about these fish is they're, look at the coloration on them. Would stop flopping around. All right, buddy, come on. Let me help you help me. Hold still.
I didn't bring my pliers today.
I got some in my pocket, but I don't think I'd had them hooked them that good. Oh. All right, buddy.
We'll get the pliers.
Like I said, the coloration on them, just look at how natural their colors are. These are good. They're good.
It's not hurting you, ain't it? There it comes.
Oh, did you get it?
Yeah. Yeah, that's a two-man job. You set the hook good on that one, buddy.
That one's coming off.
All right.
Camera, though.
How's up there tying up? That's a nice one.
Little rainbow.
Pretty one.
Like I said, you won't find the soccer trout collars like that.
Yep. I'm up here tying on again. I got hung up. Brandon is laying the hammer down on these trout today. Oh, got me one. There we go. Nice one too. Finally broke the streak. Hey, there, yeah, he unhooked himself and I kept my worm too. Man.
Like I said, I call it just dragging it through the current. Like I said, man, you just can't beat the collars on these fish.
It's just the way they're supposed to look.
All the speckles, and you got that ice highlight pink coming down the side. You'll never see them look like that coming out of a stock.
Yeah.
Let it go.
Now, G2G.
You hear that? That's my tire. I think it's rubbing.
Maybe too big. Just go down the. You don't even have to get back out on the main road. Just follow this road then. When you get there to the bridge, turn right and go across the tracks instead of going back out to 52.
Brandon's putting on a clinic right now. He's gonna get me some of these trophy. Yeah,
we're gonna go give it a ride on these trophies.
Trophy trout.
Trophy hole coming up.
Say trophy trout 5 times fast, right?
Trophy trout.
Go across the tracks here? Or?
Yeah, right across the tracks here. This used to be the basketball capital of the world.
Yeah. Sure did, didn't it, buddy?
8 straight. I still think that's a record for boys.
I think so.
I think some girls team in New Jersey won 9 straight at the actual overall record.
Yeah.
Now, I still think 8 straight's the record for boys.
This way?
Yeah, just go straight up. You'll come up and then we'll drop down and you'll see the train bridge on your left. That's the trophy hole. You ain't got to worry. There, there are like 3 people that live to the left there. I mean, you can tell all these, this hillside used to be covered with houses, but now, yeah. Heck, some of them, most of them aren't even, that's me. I'm not supposed to be in there.
That's okay.
Like I said, we're barely going a mile.
Hopping up the road here. Make me comfortable.
Now you can wade all that with waders.
Yeah.
Do pretty good, but like I said, I want to get in, see if we can get some of these trophies down here, because I know there's plenty of 20-inch trout swimming around in this hole.
I got to catch a good one, I hope.
If they're willing to bite.
You know, I technically didn't get mine in my hands.
So you had it right there.
I got it up on the bank, but.
It was about 12 inches or so, wasn't it, at least?
Yeah, it was decent. It was decent.
I mean, you know.
Better than what I'd. Better than what I had caught before that, which was nothing.
Well, you caught that piece of paper. I don't know exactly what that was, but. Right there.
Right here at the bridge, just
yes,
park
sir.
Right here?
Yeah, you can just pull right up.
All right. This is my lucky spot.
We're going to do it. 20 inch trout coming up.
Woo!
Woo!
The trophy. You got the trophy, brother.
The one we came for. Alright. What you have to do, what I call this is just a simple drag fishing technique. It's just a small creek. It's light line, small hooks, small sinker. You have to get out of that mindset when you're bass fishing. You know, I look at this little post right here. You want to cast right at that post if you're bass fishing because you're using heavier weight. When you're using these lighter weights and in creeks with current, what you want to do is you want to look at that post, but you want to go upstream a good 20-30 feet. what you'll do is you'll just pitch it up through there, and what you're doing is you're letting the current do the work. These fish, they post up in the current and the riprap and everything, and they just wait for that food to come to them as they're eating, and they just gobble it up. The trout are very voracious eaters. They'll eat anything that hits the water, bugs, worms, anything. And like I said, they just sit there in the current and wait for them to come down. So what you're doing is, if you see a spot that you want to fish, you want to go upstream a little bit, and that's where you want to cast, because with the lighter sinker, it's going to bring it down into that strike zone as it gets right to that piece of structure. That's the key. That's really the biggest thing.
I'm going to catch on to that here sometime today.
That's the biggest thing with the type of fishing that we're doing today. It's an easy tactic. Easy for even the beginner.
Put my rod in here so it don't disappear on me. Put the keys back there. This ain't a fall that I'd like to catch on camera either. I have to walk like a pregnant lady across that bridge. A real adventure, buddy. It's a real adventure, dude. You're taking me to parts of McDowell County I've never been before.
A cow right now.
I mean, I've been on the road. Baby. Oh, I see. Yeah.
15 right there for sure. That's a good one. Still ain't got to them big browns though.
No, but see, you gotta throw what you're comfortable with, ain't it? I'm not used to throwing live bait, man. It definitely works for you. He got double hooked. Try not to hurt him. It's pretty. Come on out there. First cast, dude. First cast. When I switched. I threw it right in his mouth. I didn't. It barely had time to hit the water. I feel better. Got another one. This one's better. This one's a nice one. Oh yeah, and this one's pretty too. Stay down. Stay down, baby. Stay down. Yeah, that one's that's pretty. Get up on the bank. Yeah. Yeah, that one's a pretty one there, buddy. I might have got my TV. Don't go in the water. Whew. Lord have mercy. Yeah, that could be my PB trout, buddy. Yeah. Yep. Two casts, two fish. It's much more comfortable for me. It did it just now because I said that, but yeah, you can just tell it what to do and it starts right up and it'll stop the same way. Got another one. This one's a nice one too. This one's a nice one. This one's better than the last one. Calm down. Don't get hurt. Don't hurt yourself, buddy. I'm gonna let you go. I'm gonna need your pliers. This one got hooked in the roof of the mouth. Hold on, buddy. I don't know, I might have got him. Yeah. Yeah, he didn't get hurt too bad. He's going to, if you don't calm down. Jeez Louise. Slippery, dude. Jeez. Lord of mercy. He got some kick, you know what I'm saying? He need to hook. He gopped off mine and went to yours, dude.
Pretty good, but I can't see
him,
but I know it's good
because
he's taking the drag.
I got the camera on, bro. I seen him. It's official. Can you tell what it is yet?
Rainbow.
That's a pretty one. Watch out, that hole somewhere there, dude.
Yeah, that's a pretty one. They got good color, these native trout, don't they, man? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I knew something was wrong. I got a bird's nest. Oh yeah, he's pretty. Come on, buddy. He's a pretty one. He's growling at me. He's mad. He's mad at me. I'm trying to get it out. Open your mouth.
There you go, Jason. There's
a TV brown. I can't. It's hook's turned funny, dude. I might need your pliers. Try not to hurt his jaw, you know. Hold on, I got it turned around some here.
Get him.
Yeah, I'm just trying not to do much damage. Don't get hurt, buddy.
TV brown, isn't it?
It's pretty. He's a good one. Well, we concluded our day. What do you say we caught?
About at least 35, 40 fish, at least in that range.
Yeah, we got some nice ones down through there.
Yeah, about at least five or six 16 inches.
That place,
15, 16 inches.
The place is a lot less pressured. Because that Elkhorn, like you say, it's pretty popular.
They pressure the big part of the creek, especially where we were at in North Fork, pretty hard. But the last place, a couple places we went, they're not as much pressure, nowhere near it. And you could tell because there was a lot more fish willing to play with us. And we had a good day.
A lot better day once I switched. Pulled my switch over, you know what I mean?
Give up the ghost and go back to what you knew.
I tried. I gave it all I had.
That's a lesson for you, though. Just no matter what, stick to what you
know. Stick to what you know, yeah. I'll try anything once, buddy.
There you go.
Almost.
Well, within reason.
Yeah. Yeah, it was... I was getting frustrated.
I could tell you, man. Like I said, I knew you were... I knew it was wearing on your face because... You know, I could just see over there. I could see that kind of, you get that stare and your face kind of draws down and you're like.
I said, man, this is humbling.
I remember you saying that exact thing. I remember you're like, man, this is really humbling. So I'm sitting there. I was trying to be quiet. I was like, man, I'm like, this dude needs to catch some fish.
I just couldn't get in the groove with that, man.
Well, like I said, at least you got that.
Yeah.
I said,
enough. I'm going to do what I know how to do and die by it.
I got to do me.
I gotta be me.
Because, like I said, I know, I could just see it. Like I said, I had at least 20 plus fish that time.
I had two.
And one of them you didn't even touch.
Yeah.
One of them you got it right up to your hands and it just dropped right in the water. And then the other one was barely big enough to fit in your hand. So I knew the frustration was there. The struggle was real.
Yeah, that's for sure. Then two casts, two fish, and I was back in the game.
I thought it was three. Didn't you hit it three casts in a row? Or I mean, maybe
it was like three out of five.
I knew you
right
hit
there.
I knew you hit it pretty quick there.
And then I was back in the game.
And I caught a couple of rainbows, and I caught that one brown.
That's a good little stretch through there, man.
You
for
caught
real.
Another brown too. Right
yeah. Yeah, I caught six or seven then through there, man. But that's all I caught. Was that one stretch. That's the only place I know how to fish.
Well, yeah, at least it wasn't a total skunk. The skunk was out.
But that, like I said, though, up above that probably a quarter of a mile is where I put in that one time and got in that. And I was fishing with spinners and, you know, little cranks then, catching them in the trout.
Like I said, if you... I've just found that the live bait works good for me, but how don't let me tell you how to fish.
No, but I wanted to try it though, dude. And you were catching them. I couldn't grab.
Put them on the bank. I mean, you know, you couldn't argue that it works.
Yeah.
Because it was working pretty well.
It was working for one of us.
It just wasn't working for both of us. Oh well, like I said, that's a good lesson.
GoPro, stop recording.